YouTubers, gamers, and moviegoers, what's going on, guys? I'm Masai, this is Masai Entertainment. Today we are checking out the War for the Planet of the Apes trailer number 2. Super excited about this. I really love the War, the Planet of the Apes franchise and where it's been going. I'm assuming this is the last one gearing up for, you know, that world that we see in the original Planet of the Apes, where the apes do control everything. And Woody Harrelson is in this. Looks absolutely great. He's a great actor. Let's check this thing out.
He's a smart one, isn't he?
Very reminiscent of the Justice League trailer.
Do they look like just apes to you?
He saved our lives.
He was remarkable.
God, the CGI on this thing, man, is remarkable. It really is the culmination of like all three of these movies.
You're Caesar. We've been searching for you for so long.
I do not start this war. I fight only to protect apes.
It's advanced.
Human gets sick, ape gets smart. That human kill ape, but not me. I run.
There are times when it is necessary to abandon our humanity to save humanity.
God, that looks so real!
They must pay. I'll finish this.
Oh, Caesar's out for blood, man.
I've showed you peace. I've showed you mercy.
That character, I think, is actually supposed to be one of the characters from the first movie.
No matter what you say, eventually you'd replace us. That's the law of nature. So look what you've done.
What did the humans promise you? Never be one of them. You are.
These are some really cool themes, man.
Apes together, strong. We are the beginning. Apes together, strong.
Have you come to save your apes?
This looks so good. God damn. Yo, that's how you do a trailer. I'm really loving the themes in this movie and the fact that the apes are so advanced. It's like what I just said. This is really, I think, gonna be the last film. Unless they decide to go back into the territory of those original films from the 70s? Where, you know, it was like apes rule the world. The apes are so advanced now they don't have to do the sign language sort of thing to communicate. Caesar's putting out full-length sentences with no problem. They've evolved pretty damn fast. And I'm really liking that. I don't know where the other characters, like Jason Clarke's character is, but it seems like Caesar is out full-on for blood. The humans come in, they attack, a lot of people get wiped out, I'm assuming, and then the war culminates in this big battle at the end that I'm assuming the humans are going to lose. I like that dynamic of the ape who's fighting with the humans. I was wondering that, I guess, like I said, the apes have evolved enough so that, you know, they can be used as, like, soldiers for the humans. I thought that was really interesting. And what could you promise an ape, you know, so that, you know, like, they'd fight for your side of the army? Are they having his family captive or something? You know, does he want to be part of the humans, like Caesar said? You know what I mean? Like, there's so many interesting questions with these, like, really evolved apes, and that's, like, really cool. Not to mention, the CGI on this thing is unfreaking believable. Oh my god, like, I remember when the first one came out, Rise of the Planet of the Apes, and the CGI looked good, and I was really, like, that it was a convincing monkey. Then Dawn came out and it was like, god damn, it got even better. This one comes out, it's like really hard to tell what's not, I mean, it's not hard to tell because obviously the apes aren't talking, but you know, it's like the CGI is so damn good. It clearly being CGI in your mind just kind of having to go into like a suspension of disbelief, and it just being like that damn good where it looks like it would be totally plausible to have Caesar walk around in real life. Like, it looks really good. And to see Caesar hit this low point, you know? I mean, in every film, I expected him in Dawn for him to turn on the humans, you know? And the story took a totally different direction. I was really impressed by that. It kept me on my toes.
But Caesar's always been the advocate for peace. You know what I mean? I'm really interested to see how the girl dynamic works. Like how the humans have an ape, they have a human. You know, is there any kind of conflict within her that, you know, she's, you know, on the side of a bunch of apes that basically wants to defeat her people, her species? You know, and apparently she's the character from the original one. Although she looks nothing like it, and I think this one's a blonde or whatever, and the other one looks totally different. Which makes me wonder, after this film, do they plan to make more movies in that time period where apes are ruling over humans, the humans are enslaved, and, you know, it takes place many, many years later? You know, will they come back with the spaceship like they did in the very original? Will they have, you know, all these, will they continue the franchise after this point? This one has pretty much been the prelude to those original films. And, you know, while I've loved these new films, I guess for the original fans, it would be interesting to revisit that territory in a very non-Tim Burton, Mark Wahlberg way. So I'd really like to see that. If they're heading towards that with this sort of tone and this sort of, I guess, like, grittier, kind of real, more realistic way, and then show that kind of dynamic and reverse it in terms of, like, before it's been always humans ruling and, you know, like the apes are kind of gaining control. If they flipped it and now the humans were technically the protagonists and then the apes were almost more like the villains, I think that would be really interesting. It's something that we haven't seen in this franchise yet, but I think it would be really interesting because we haven't seen it in any of these films. For these past three movies, there's been human protagonists, but the real protagonist, the main one, has been Caesar throughout all these films. So it would be interesting to see the reverse side of it. But this thing looks so freaking good. Every year that these new Planet of the Apes films are out, it's always one of my most anticipated films. I've been super looking forward to this ever since the first one started. I knew there was going to have to be some kind of conflict between humans and apes that just goes all out. I thought we were going to see it in Dawn. We didn't. And then this one, it's for sure going to happen. So I really cannot wait. Apes together is strong. Yo, but that's just my opinion. I'm sure you guys got your role. Let me know in the comment section down below, what did you guys think of the War for the Planet of the Apes trailer number 2? Did you love it? Did you hate it? As always, guys, can follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Twitch. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe, guys. Please check me out on my other channel, Directors JXM. We got cool skits and short films out for you guys, including Star Wars Reprisal, short film I did not too long ago. Be sure to check that out. I run a channel with my boy Johnny Lee. He has his own channel on JXB Entertainment. Be sure to check that out. Anyway, that's it for today, guys. I'm the Messiah. This is Messiah Entertainment. See you guys next time. Peace.